you think you have coronavirus, we ask that you call ahead if you'd like to be seen. And the reason for that is that we can be prepared for you and greet you when you come in to protect our other staff and our patients. If you have general questions or want more information, you can call our nurse line. And you can also schedule a telehealth visit if you have additional health concerns. We've closed some of our clinics just to allow more flexibility so that we can take care of you. Some closures might be anticipated coming forward as well, again, to give that flexibility so that we can meet your needs. We do have telehealth available for you, which is a great option so that you can get the care that you need in the comfort of your own homes. Telemedicine is a great way to get care. You can schedule a visit with your provider's office. It provides great flexibility for you and also keeps you safe at home if you don't need to come in to the clinic. At Scripps, we have restricted our visitor policy to no visitors unless certain circumstances exist, and you can check on those. But other than that, no visitors. If you're accompanying somebody to a clinic, we ask that you wait in the car, again, to limit flow in and out of our hospital areas and clinic areas to protect all of you. We welcome donations from the public as well. It's a great show of support for our staff as well as we're trying to protect not only our patients, but our staff and healthcare workers. We are looking for N95s, surgical masks, non-latex gloves, isolation gowns, disinfectant wipes, anything that you can think of that would help us would be greatly appreciated. And we have an email address that you can email us and we can talk to you more about how to donate. What you can do to help us is to please follow the shelter-in-place guidelines that we have out there. That's to protect you, your families, and the healthcare workers. If our healthcare workers get sick, who will take care of you? Stay home. If you're sick, self-quarantine yourselves. Please do not come to work if you're sick. Wash your hands frequently. If you have a cough or a sneeze, single tissue, put it in the trash. Avoid public areas if you can. Please keep yourselves healthy, so that we can take care of you. As an emergency physician, I will tell you that it's heartbreaking to see a loved one fighting for their lives on a ventilator. And I want you to think about what you can do now to help prevent that from happening. Please don't be one of those people that looks back and thinks, what could I have done differently? The time for action is now, and we really need your help.